My name is Paula Rubel. I'm from Maysville, Kentucky, and I'm with the Limestone Cycling Tour. And I'm one of the organizers. This will be our 10th year for the ride. And it was the first year for it was started by a friend in memory of a good friend of his that he had died early, and he wanted, and they rode bikes a lot, and he wanted to have a memorial ride in honor of Zach. So he got his friends together and other community members, and about 30 people came out and rode 25-30 miles. The following year, the local bike club, which some of those people were there that year, they were like, hey, let's do this the next year and let's continue this tradition. And every year the monies are raised to go towards an educational scholarship that had been set up in his memory, and those are donated to a local foundation. So that's kind of how it evolved, that the local bike club took on the task moving forward. In the first year we only had 2 route options, the second year we added 3. And every year it's gotten a little bit more. And so we've offered 4 routes, including a century. This will probably be our 6th year to do a century. We're also part of a local bike club called the Limestone Cycling League. And we tossed around different names of what we wanted to call our century, and which we have 4 routes, but what do we want to call our century? And the name Limestone actually is known in our area, Maysville, a lot, because that was the original name of Maysville. So back whenever bourbon was popular along our river ports and so forth, it was called Limestone. Limestone is very prominent in the area of Maysville and Mason County. We became part of the Kentucky Century Cycling Challenge. Was for 2 or 3 years. A couple of people in our bike club, Dr. Leroy Gollenstein, Ryan Smith, and several people probably watching this know them, they're like, we would love to be in this Kentucky Century Challenge. How do we get in there? And they'd say, we talked to Pam Thomas about it. How do we get in there? And so they looked at me and said, Paula, how do we get in here? So I started contacting Pam and finding out the details and whether or not there was an opening that our ride could be part of it, because there was only 5 selected rides. Of course, the Horsey 100 and the Redbud are the anchor rides, and the other 3 spots can be taken for a 2 or 3 year period. And so that's how we became part of it. We found out the details, and we got sponsors, local sponsors, our Maysville Tourism Office, very supportive, as well as our Mason County Fiscal Court, because they know right away that we want to bring people into our area to cycle and show off our community. The first year we had probably about 30 people participate. Every year we've had around the 50 mark. Last year we had closer to 100. Now that we've gotten into the Kentucky Century Cycling Challenge, we are getting close to at least a 300 mark at this particular date that I'm talking, but we've got several weeks to go, and so we're really planning for 400 to 500 cyclists coming in. We currently have cyclists signed up from 14 different states, as well as Germany. So we have 4 ride routes offered. Well, we have a 25-mile loop, a 40-mile loop, a metric century, and a century. There could be a little tweak in route options as far as what's online, because you kind of have to look really close and make sure that any routes might have to be changed a little bit due to construction or something like that. But they will head out of town towards the Cincinnati area, but on the, obviously on the Kentucky side, towards Dover, Kentucky, and Augusta, Kentucky. 2 of the routes are going to head up a hill called Big Heine, okay, the metric and the century, before heading into Minerva and down into Augusta. The 25-mile and the 40-milers will continue together on down to what's called Lee's Creek. And all of the routes are supported. We have 7 sag stops for the century you're going to be excited to see a lot of fun themes around our areas of the sag stops. Not all of them are themed, but we have some fun things in store for you. We have the group in Augusta, Kentucky that has a nice surprise, the Augusta sag stop. You're going to love. It's right along the river. Shade trees, you'll see some river traffic, I'm sure, that day. No guarantee, but I'm sure there'll be some boats and barges and recreational boats going through. And there'll be some things, nice surprises there. And then there's a town called Germantown that those century and metric riders will go through. And it is Oktoberfest season, so we might have a little surprise there. And then we go on out to Maysville and Old Washington. And there's actually in the town of Old Washington, which is just outside of Maysville, there's a Simon Kenton Festival going on that weekend. So there'll be, you might even catch a reenactment of Civil War that's going on down in the field that's close by. So there'll be some other fun things going on in the area. So there are five segments that are notable on our ride. So one of them is called the Big Heine. It does start at river level off of Route 8, makes a few curves, and at the top you will be glad to just have a nice shady area to rest. Another one is on Vermilion. That is another hill that has a few twists and turns. Some people call it the Viper because it does kind of twist and turn a few times. Another one for the 25 miler and the 40 miler is off of Lee's Creek. And it's really the one hill on the 25 miler that would be the most challenging. Let's plan to come in Friday evening, and you can pick up your packets from 4 to 7 at Limestone Landing. The start, the finish, the packet pickup is at 101 Limestone Street, downtown Maysville. You can enjoy our city, walk around, go have dinner, something like that. But from 4 to 7 on Friday evening. There'll also be a pre-ride that evening for anyone that wants to warm up their legs a bit. They'll be leaving at 6 o'clock from Limestone Landing. On Saturday morning, we'll open back up for packet pickup. 6 o'clock, we'll be down there. Suggested to leave around 7, but no later than 9. If you're signed up by August 29th, you will receive a free event t-shirt, okay? Everyone will also, except for the 25 miler, you will also get a food voucher that is good at one of 6 locations that are close by in downtown Maysville. So that'll be included, plus of course, map cues, SAG support. We also are having some live entertainment from 2 to 6, so that to welcome cyclists back in and hang out for a while. Wessex Brewery will be there, Capital Bicycles will be set up, L8 of course will be set up. We're gonna have massage therapy available. So yeah, so just plan to stay and hang out for a while with us and hopefully spend the night. You can stay over in Maysville an extra night and get the post ride, recovery ride on Sunday morning. The time of that and the routes will be posted soon. I think it's around 10 o'clock that morning for a short ride. So also just hang out in our town and check it out. It's beautiful. Our ride is would not be possible without our sponsors. We totally appreciate all of their help and support. We also have multiple local supporters and sponsors. And also, thanks ahead of time and in the past to all of our volunteers, people on our committee, in our bike club, and in the community as a whole. It's one big, takes a whole village, I guess you might say, to pull this all off, and it's very appreciated. So to get more information about the Limestone Cycling Tour, go to our website, of course, www.limestonecyclingtour.com. It's very easy to find. You can also have links to our Facebook and Twitter, and we're on Instagram as well, and all the links are on our website there. Also a link to register. All four of our routes are posted on our website. So as long as you remember the name of our ride, limestonecyclingtour.com, you'll be able to get all your information there. You can shoot us an email if you have any additional questions that you can't find answered on the website.
Hi everyone, I hope you enjoyed this episode of the Kentucky Cycling Connections series. The Kentucky Cycling YouTube channel is a volunteer effort aimed at promoting cycling in the Bluegrass region. You can support this work by sharing the videos on social media. Also, please like the video on YouTube and subscribe to the channel. Thanks.